Hello everyone, welcome to Remedy 24. Today we're going to show you what is diverticulitis and how does it affect you? A healthy digestive system is extremely important to us. It is intertwined with our physical and emotional well-being. Unfortunately, a number of things can go wrong with our digestive systems and make us sick. One potential problem is diverticulitis. It's a potential side effect of a rather prevalent ailment that many people will have even if they aren't aware of it. It is rarely dangerous, although it can deteriorate into something more serious in a small percentage of instances. The sickness can be treated, and the milder kinds are usually easy to deal with. 1. Diverticulitis. Our digestive juice's caustic nature is shielded by specialized tissues that line our digestive tract. Diverticulosis is a condition in which the walls of the patient's digestive tract develop bulges known as divertica. They are a common condition that doesn't usually cause any symptoms in the person. These pouches are most likely to be found in the colon. Although there are usually no symptoms, some persons may experience difficulties as a result of the illness. It's possible that the pouches will become irritated at times, which can be aggravating. Diverticulitis is a condition that can be life-threatening, but it is also curable. 2. Causes. Some parts of the intestine's walls are weaker than others, and they can give way and push outwards if too much pressure is given to them. As a result, diverticula, which are little pouches about the size of a marble, might form. These pouches can tear from time to time, causing inflammation and diverticulitis. These tears can cause irritation and allow infections to grow in the digestive system's lining, in addition to generating inflammation. As a result, a bevy of unpleasant symptoms will manifest. 3. Pain. Perhaps the most common sign of diverticulitis is pain. The pain commonly occurs on the left side of the abdomen, but it can also occur on the right side. Asian heritage people are more likely to have the latter. In any case, the discomfort will almost certainly last for days and will be persistent. The patient may acquire a fever if he or she contracts an infection. Another symptom of diverticulitis is constipation, whereas diarrhea affects a smaller number of people with a condition. These warning signs and symptoms should lead you to contact your doctor as soon as possible. 4. Complications. In addition to the symptoms already stated, 25% of people with diverticulitis will develop additional problems. This is caused by a buildup of pus in the diverticula, which can result in abscesses. These abscesses have the potential to burst and release a large amount of poison into the patient's body. Scarring of the digestive tract lining can also cause food to become blocked. A fistula, a medical term for an uneven contour joining two body regions, can also develop. These are concerns that should be addressed as soon as they are identified, as they can cause serious problems if not addressed. 5. Peritonitis. The peritoneum is a protective membrane that lines the inside wall of the abdomen. The membrane, which contains some of our most critical organs, surrounds much of the digestive system. Peritonitis is a disorder in which the membrane between the intestines becomes inflamed. Inflammation can be caused by a variety of things, including diverticulitis. Diverticulitis can cause the contents of the intestines to leak into the abdominal cavity through a burst diverticula, causing extensive harm. Peritonitis is a potentially fatal illness that necessitates prompt medical intervention. 6. Risk factors. Diverticulitis can affect everyone. However, some people are more prone to the disease than others. Obese people are more likely to have this ailment, and it becomes more prevalent as people get older. People who do not get enough exercise are also at a higher risk of developing the disease. Smoking is another issue. Non-smokers have a lower risk of acquiring diverticulitis. Some medications, such as non-steroidal anti-inflammatory drugs, NSAIDs, like ibuprofen, may increase your risk. Diverticulitis is more likely to develop in those who eat a diet high in animal fats and low in fiber. 7. Prevention. Diverticulitis can strike at any time, but there are some things you can do to lower your chances of getting it. This mostly comprises adopting a healthy lifestyle, with smoking cessation being one of the most effective techniques for preventing a number of ailments. A high-fiber diet, consisting of a range of fruits and vegetables, is also recommended. Staying away from fatty foods is also a smart idea. It will also help if you drink plenty of water, as it will ease digestion. Exercising can also help you lose weight and keep your bowels in good working order. 8. Diagnosis. Tests will almost probably be required to make a diagnosis because the symptoms of diverticulitis can be caused by a range of different medical conditions. A quick physical examination, on the other hand, may be performed to look for signs of other medical problems. To rule out infections, a stool test may be done in conjunction with other assays. A pregnancy test, as well as urine and blood samples for examination, may be conducted. A liver enzyme test may be requested, as well as a CT scan to help diagnose diverticulitis. 9. Medication. Diverticulitis treatment is mostly decided on the severity of the disease. Antibiotics are commonly used in treatment, however, they are not always required. Instead, the patient is typically advised to consume only liquids in order to enable the sickness to heal on its own. If the situation is more serious, stronger antibiotics that can be given intravenously may be required. The patient will almost probably need to be brought to the hospital so that antibiotics can be provided through a saline drip. Medication is all that is required in the great majority of cases. 10. Surgery. In some cases, it may be necessary to drain any abscesses, which is usually done by inserting a tube. More surgical treatments may be required if the medicine isn't working or if the patient has a medical condition that could lead to complications. Perforations and fistulas may also need to be repaired. A primary bowel resection, which involves removing infected and/or damaged parts of the gut, may be performed. Another alternative is a colon resection with a colostomy, which involves putting a bag into which waste can pass. The bag is frequently removed as the patient's condition improves.